We have the medal ceremony for the women race that is going on at the moment, and I'd like us to go to that medal award ceremony first, then we'll come back to our panel here.
Outside the top three, third in 2016, second in 2017, and second once again here. Also second in Tokyo earlier in the year. She's got a great future ahead of her, still only 24 years old. Ruti Agger then, coming home in second place in the Berlin Marathon. But, well, victory for the third time for Gladys Cherono, the defending champion. Winner in 2015. She was injured in 2016. She came back last year and won again in the rain and the cold to win for the second time. And today, it's victory number three. A hat-trick for Gladys Cherono in a brilliant new course record. 2:18.11. She knocked 61 seconds off the previous mark. And she made it a Kenyan double, not for the first time. And when the break came at 25 kilometers, it was decisive. And she used all her experience, all her knowledge of the course, to great effect. And the Kenyan broke the resolve of the two Ethiopians you can see there behind her. And a €40,000 prize money for Gladys Cherono, a three-time winner. And she joins Aberu Kebede, Uta Pivit and Renata Kokovska as a three-time Berlin champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand.
Victory then of Kenya. For Gladys Cherono of Kenya. Yes, indeed. Congratulations to Gladys Cherono. Brilliant new lifetime best. And there, confirmation of the top three. And when that break came, it was decisive, wasn't it? 23 seconds, the winning margin. And almost the same again between second and third. Look out for Ruti Agger, though. She is a very, very special talent. And you guess, you imagine that she may well be taking on the baton from Tirunesh Dibaba, who of course has still got plenty of marathons left in her, but at 24 years old, Ruti Agger. And Cherono now, that 2:18.11, now fourth on the all-time list, still headed by Paula Radcliffe. Mary Kitani, of course, posting the second fastest time of all time at the London Marathon in 2017. Tirunesh Dibaba herself is the third fastest at 2:17.56. And now Gladys Cherono, with that performance today, has gone from 10th up to 4th in the all-time list. That's the mark of that performance today. A terrific performance. So, Tim, quality not just in the men's race today. We shouldn't underestimate what an achievement that is by Gladys Cherono today on the world stage.
No, and it's a double whammy, isn't it, Chris? I always laugh when I see those beer glasses about the same size as the poor lady trying to carry them. But it's a double whammy because look at those times. Three athletes today in the same race under 2:19. That is a first. Never achieved that strength in depth in a women's marathon. And of course, a fabulous new course record by a big chunk by Gladys Cherono today. Over 1 minute, the improvement of the Berlin course record. And to become the fourth fastest in history, well, it's not a world record. You don't become number two, number three, but it's right up there, isn't it, as a massive achievement in any athlete's career. She's used to winning. It's her third Berlin victory, as you rightly said. But the significance of becoming one of the very quickest in history out of the tens of thousands who have attempted to be good marathon runners is not one to be underestimated. The wind picking up just a tiny bit, some of those flags there, which now being lowered to the right of picture from the women's presentation ceremony. I'm sure they'll be replaced by the flags appropriately for the men's presentation ceremony very shortly. But look at the Brandenburg Gate there, it's the top left, the victory chariot. The flags up there are blowing a little bit more stiffly, aren't they? From the south, by the looks of things, a southwesterly wind, which is what was predicted. But of course, down on ground level, amongst the buildings of the German capital, you're really well sheltered from the wind. You hardly feel anything. Well, we will very shortly get the men's presentation ceremony underway. And the cheers for the achievement today of the Berlin champion surely have to be amongst the loudest ever heard at one of the Abbott World Marathon major races. This was, just to remind you, the first race of Series 12 for the Abbott World Marathon major series. It's a six group member group at the World Marathon major races, but the series lasts seven races. Berlin today starts Series 12 and it will finish Series 12 in terms of the scoring for the athletes. Each of these men has scored good points. Eliud Kipchoge to the right of picture there, looking fully recovered. All three of them in pretty good shape, including this man in third place, 36-year-old Wilson Kipsang. His time, 2 hours, 6 minutes and 48 seconds in his 21st marathon. He yet again goes a long, long way under 2:10. He's already a legend. He's four times he's broken 2:04. Eight times he's broken 2:05. Nobody else in history can boast that. He was fourth at the World Championships here back in 2009. So that, in effect, was actually his Berlin Marathon debut on a multi-lap course at those World Championships, what, 9 years ago. But he enjoyed this one today. I suspect deep down inside he surprised himself a little bit with how well he rallied, and he really maximized his potential here today. He was a late starter at the age of 20, and he's hanging on pretty well, isn't he, Wilson Kipsang? Third today, one place behind this young man. A happy birthday to Amos Kipruto of Kenya. It was a 1-2-3 in the men's race for Kenya indeed. His time, 2 hours, 6 minutes and 23 seconds. 40 seconds slower than his personal best from 5 years ago in Amsterdam, but an improvement by 10 seconds on his 2018 best. He was third in Tokyo back in February, second today in Berlin. It's been a fabulous run by this athlete. You can boast good speed. He has a 60-minute 24 personal best for the half marathon. No track pedigree, Amos Kipruto. He's one of that generation of young Kenyans who has stepped straight onto the roads. The financial rewards are massively outweigh those available for a solid track performer, even at world class. Well, speaking of world class, let's call him now not only world class, not only the retaining champion of Berlin, but the world record holder, Eliud Kipchoge, at the old age of 33, is at last atop the pile with the letters WR beside his name. 2 hours, 1 minute and 39 seconds, a monstrous improvement of 1 minute and 18 seconds on Dennis Kometa's four-year-old world record. His halves were 61.06 and 60.34, almost superhuman, that second half of his Berlin journey today. He averaged 252.9 per kilometre. For each 10-kilometre segment, listen to this, he averaged 28.49. And for those of you who love a few stats, his half marathon average for each of the two halves today, 60 minutes and 49 seconds. It was quite simply breathtaking. And he, in truly superhuman style, had plenty of energy left to celebrate after the race with his coach, with the throng behind the finish line, and then with the crowds. He almost looks like he'd do it all over again, doesn't he? Records, of course, are made to be broken. The medals, well, they last forever. He has a world championship gold from 15 years ago at 5,000 meters. He has an Olympic gold medal from Rio just over 2 years ago. Those will never be taken from him. This record one day will be improved, but I strongly suspect, as we hear the Kenyan national anthem, this record will last for a long, long time, unless he improves it himself.
To Eliud Kipchoge. Der 11. Weltrekord, der hier in Berlin gelaufen wurde.
Well, that performance from Eliud Kipchoge, the win and a new world record by well over a minute, should be on the front page of every significant journal around the world tomorrow. I'm sure it won't be. This is sport, it's not life and death. But nonetheless, it is a huge moment in the annals of endurance sport, and it's hard to think of anything quite as majestic as this performance today, Chris. Paula Radcliffe's win in 2003 on the female side in London in that world record 2:15.25, a time which you rightly said is still unapproached, is probably equivalent to this, if not better, because nobody's come within 2 minutes of it. But nonetheless, Kipchoge here today has done something which, if you look at other endurance sports, cycling and triathlon and swimming, it's really hard to think of something that compares.
It's been a real privilege, hasn't it? Really has, to have witnessed some genuine history here. It's hard to see, apart from Kipchoge himself, who could begin to challenge that mark. And if you look at the top three we've been giving you the results, I mean, second place, 5 minutes behind, that was the winning margin today. 5 minutes, for goodness sake.
There it is, 4 minutes, 44 behind, yeah. Nearly 5 minutes.
Yeah, it's extraordinary.
And I think one of the reasons that I believe that this will be a tough record to improve upon, unless he does it himself in the next couple of years, is that Kipchoge is the complete rounded runner. He's got it all. He's got speed. He's got strength. He's got endurance in both those areas. He's got wonderful poise. He's a classical build for a marathon runner. He's relatively small in stature and yet wonderfully proportioned, wonderful musculature, great mentality, has that calmness, that sort of Zen Buddhist calmness.
Yes, and the work ethic, of course, to go with it, and the humility. We've mentioned that before. He's from a farming background, as many of the Kenyan elite are. He leads a pretty simple life up at Eldoret there with his wife and family, and utterly dedicated to getting better and better. And just interesting reading some of the quotes from his agent, Valentin, who was saying that actually Eliud is still learning about the distance. He's still learning. And that was, for me, actually quite telling in reading that a couple of days before this race, because actually he was already, as we said right at the top of the program, he was already the greatest marathon runner we've ever seen on the male side. And if the greatest marathon runner ever to have lived is still learning about the event, my goodness, and so it proved today.
No, exactly right. So this was his 11th marathon, if we discount the sub 2 event in Monza back in May 2017. How many more good marathons has he got in him? You know, I think you're probably hitting your peak. I know it's easy to say he's still learning about the race, but what could you have taught him today? What could you have learned today? Has he found anything out about himself today that he didn't already know, or did he just apply what he already knew?